most pitches are the same. You get to the office, they ask you to wait in the, like a doctor's office, to wait out in the lobby. You sit on a couch, they bring you something to drink. Then they say, okay, it's time for you to go in and do your pitch. You walk in and meet the executive or whoever the buyer is. Usually you shake hands, you say hello, you introduce yourself a little bit in terms of who you are in case they don't know it. You ask them a little bit about themselves and their company, so there's a little bit of small talk. Small talk can be 30 seconds, it can be 5 minutes. You ask a question, the guy might want to talk to you for 20 minutes, or he might want to say, I don't have much time, let's get to the story. Because usually when you're in these pitch meetings, these people hear pitches all day long, they don't want you to waste their time. They appreciate when you say, look, the reason I came today is, and you get right into your story. And then you proceed to pitch, and you tell, basically, I would start with what the high concept is in a log line. I would tell them right up front, this is a story that uses the Wizard of Oz, and it's all about what happens when the witch comes to New York. This is how it works. And then I go into a 5-minute pitch, which is, in Act One, we introduce the character of Dorothy, or we introduce the character that Katherine Heigl's gonna play, and that is the girl from the, you know, sketch artist story I told earlier. And by the end of 5 minutes, I've done Act One, Act Two, and Act Three. I've sort of summarized the movie, and I've only been talking for 5 minutes or less, maybe 7 to 10 minutes max. 20-minute pitches that many people like to do are not what most executives and buyers want to hear, because by the end of 2 or 3 minutes, they already know if they like it. And to go on for another 15 or 20 minutes, when they already like it or don't, it's very hard for them to pay attention.
You're either digging a hole deeper or ruining your...
Yeah, I would think you can tell if they like it. They usually get involved. They usually want to come up with suggestions. They interrupt sometimes in a good way or a bad way. The more they want to contribute, the more you want to let them, because that makes them feel invested in your idea. At the end of 10 or 15 minutes at the most, you've been in the room for 15 or 20 minutes at the most, you say, and that's the way the story ends. And then you can say, any questions? And if they want to talk about it, they will. If they say, no, I really understand it, that's code for leave my office because I have another meeting.
Right.
You thank them and say, it was great, I really appreciate you giving me the time. Your main thing is to be well-dressed without being overdressed, polite, get in and get out, and know that maybe now that you've made a relationship, you ask them, in fact, if you don't like this one, I'd love to be able to call you or write you, and down the line, maybe in a few months, you'd be willing to see me again. And usually they'll say yes, even if they don't mean it. Mm-hmm. But at least you've made a relationship, and you can call them again in a few weeks or a few months and go see them again. You establish enough of those meetings, you've got people you can go see regularly. So the pitch meeting is an opportunity for you to tell your story, but also make a relationship.